Ladies, getting your groove back might not require a trip to Jamaica. A female sex drive pill might be here very soon. Hello everyone, Amy here with you on D News today. Sildenafil, sold under the trade name Viagra, might be the most well-known pill on the market. And while almost everyone knows that it's used to treat sexual disorders like erectile dysfunction, not everyone knows how it works. Viagra does not cause sexual arousal in men. It only works if the man is aroused, and in that case it helps that arousal along by managing the chemistry that causes a man to get an erection. Specifically, it maintains the levels of messenger cyclic guanosine monophosphate that stimulates erectile tissue. But sexual dysfunction works a little differently for women. Though some are physical, many female sexual disorders come down to mental and emotional factors leading to disinterest in sex and an overall low sex drive, properly called hypoactive sexual desire disorder. Arousal and disinterest in sex are still somewhat unknown to scientists, although they do know that the brain's circuitry is involved. One theory is that low sex drive results from an inability to switch off the frontal parts of the brain that manage everyday tasks, mundane things like remembering to go to the post office or resolve a problem at work. With these frontal parts switched on, the reward circuitry that manages motivation and pleasure is left behind, and this means women can't really get into sex. But there's a weird silver lining. Like erectile dysfunction in men, low sex drive is chemical, and that is something treatable. The female version of this little blue pill is called flibanserin, and it's currently pending approval by the FDA. There's a meeting to decide its fate early next month. Flibanserin was initially developed as an antidepressant, but while women in a clinical trial didn't notice a change in mood, they did find themselves more interested in sex. It was dropped as an antidepressant and refocused to treat women's waning libidos. This drug, it seems, tweaks the balance of key neurotransmitters dopamine, noradrenaline, and serotonin, either normalizing levels or compensating for imbalances to bring these circuits back to optimal levels, disengaging the frontal circuits that inhibit sex drive. And while the women who tried it didn't see a massive result, they still noticed a positive trend. Of course, measuring an improvement in this case is pretty hard. It seems women don't have a lot of sex on average, just 3 times per month. During the trial, women on flibanserin had about 2.5 sexual events in 4 weeks, while women not on the drug with low sex drive had just 1.5 sexual events per month. Of course, there are other factors that affect a woman's sex drive, like self-esteem issues and disinterest in a relationship, and these aren't necessarily things that should be dealt with medically. And sex drive does wane with age, though this does vary between individuals. Some women experience a marked drop in sex drive after menopause, while others may experience a renewed sexual awakening. But if a younger woman is in an otherwise loving relationship, flibanserin, if it is passed by the FDA, could be the boon to women that Viagra has been for men. And if you do have more sex, maybe it could lead you to making more money. Julia explores that finding in this D News video right here.
Researchers reviewed data from 7,500 participants and found those who had sex 2 or 3 times a week made 4.5% more income than their less frisky coworkers.
So ladies, would you turn to a pill to fix an ailing sex drive? Let us know in the comments below, or let us know on Twitter at D News, and I'm on Twitter as well as AST Vintage Space. And of course, for more D News every single day of the week, don't forget to subscribe.